Hello friends, Mohit Sehgal here from linguistica7.com, and today we are discussing pronunciations. What did I say? Oh, pronunciations. Tricky, isn't it? Now, being non-native English speakers, we tend to sometimes mispronounce certain words because of the way mostly they're spoken around us. While this may be harmless in case of local audience where everybody knows you, but when it comes to a more discerning audience or when the stakes are high, such as an interview or any situation like that, certain things can become somewhat of a concern. So today we're going to take 16 to 17 of such words, and we're going to make sure that with the help of some very simple pronunciation aids, you rectify these words and you pronounce them and remember them correctly. I hope you'll find this little session entertaining as well as surprising. Let's begin. All right, then, we begin with our first word, which very fittingly is this. Because let's face it, if I cannot get this word right, I have no right teaching you what I'm about to. So this word right here is pronunciation, as opposed to the common error, which is pronunciation. And this confusion is understandable because this is the noun that is pronunciation, but its verb form comes out to be pronounce. So people tend to wonder, is it pronunciation? Is it pronunciation? Let's set the record straight. It is pronunciation. Let's clarify that with the help of some speaking aids. Let's see. So first I'm going to go for the wrong version, which is pro. Then you've got your noun. We'll add a C in here. For the A sound, I put in an A-Y. And shun. So I've broken the word into different syllables. What do we have? Pronunciation. Where's your problem? There's your problem. Let's come to the correct version now. Pro, instead of N-O-U-N, I'm going to write N-U-N. And the rest remains the same. What do we have? Pronunciation. If you can remember this, believe me, you'll never go wrong. Pronunciation as opposed to pronunciation, the way a word is spoken. So before we get on with this, I thought it'll be the best idea to begin with this very word, pronunciation, and not pronunciation, the way any word is spoken, pronunciation. All right, then we come to our second word, which is this. Now, what generally goes wrong while pronouncing this word is that, unfortunately, this little guy does not get the attention that it deserves. And we come out with tuition. Tuition, by which we mean teaching or instruction in especially small groups. So what do we say? Sentences such as, I need to pay my college tuition. Let's get that right. The word definitely includes the pronunciation of the letter I, and the correct pronunciation is tuition. Yes, not tuition, but tuition. So you need to pay for your college tuition and not tuition. Let's understand that with the help of a pronunciation aid. First, let's go with the wrong version, which is tuition. Now, shun, interestingly, means avoid. So what you've done is that you have avoided the I sound here. So you come out with tuition. Let's not do that. Let's give I the right that it deserves. And we come out with the right version, which is tuition. Tuition. So I'm going to attend my maths tuition and not tuition. So that's the word, tuition. Let's change tuition permanently to tuition today. Now, this interestingly brings me to another word which is a close cousin as far as the pronunciation is concerned, and that is intuition, right? So I'm just going to add an in behind the word tuition. Intuition, by which I guess you already know, by which I mean a hunch or a gut feeling of something to happen in the future. To explain the meaning with the help of a sentence, I can say something like, I have an intuition that my exam may not go well. So I hope you heard that word over there, intuition, which is also incorrectly pronounced as intuition because of the fact that we are avoiding the same I in there. Let's not do that. Pronounce that I and you get intuition, which means a gut feeling. So if you are feeling something about the future, that something's going to happen, that's not your intuition, but that's your intuition. So the two words that we learned here are tuition, which should be pronounced as tuition, and its close cousin, intuition, which should be rectified and spoken as intuition. Tuition and intuition. We come to our next word, which is this. Now, generally, the mistake that happens while pronouncing this is we tend to pronounce this word as envelope, which not only messes up the pronunciation, it also changes the meaning, because envelope, or rather envelope, means to cover something. But what you need to mention over here is that paper cover, or the wrapper in which you insert your letter and mail it away. So to get that right, you need to change the pronunciation from envelope to envelope. This O-P-E gets the due attention that it deserves. O-P-E should come out as ope, which is why this word is to be pronounced as envelope and not envelope. Let's check out the wrong version and the right version with the help of some phonetic spellings. So the wrong version first, we tend to pronounce it as envelope. Envelope, or envelope, like I earlier said, means to cover. But how to signify that paper cover? The correct version is envelope. Envelope. This ope will be pronounced in the same way you do in the English word hope, or rather in the word elope. So let's not elope away from our right pronunciation and pronounce this as envelope. Envelope, that little paper cover in which you insert your letter to mail it. You got envelope and not envelope. Envelope. And on to our fourth word, which is the first meal of the day, that is this. So the wrong pronunciation is often spoken as breakfast. And people are not wrong to say it that way, because yes, if you break the words in your mind, what do you get? If I break the word over here, any reasonable person with a reasonable knowledge of English would say break and fast. Unfortunately, when these two separate words combine, the pronunciation dynamics tend to differ. Right now, the wrong pronunciation, break fast, as you can see it right here, you got break and fast. But the correct version, let's have a look at that. When you rectify the pronunciation, you get something like, that's a K, by the way. Sometimes my cursive gets weird. And then you come to first. What do you get? Breakfast, break, and fast. Forget for a minute that this word means break. This is pronounced as break, and this is pronounced as fast. When they come together, they give birth to an altogether different pronunciation, which is breakfast. So from now on, in case if you've been saying it wrong, the first meal of your day is not breakfast, rather breakfast. So that's your B-R-E-A-K-F-A-S-T, which is breakfast. Coming to our fifth word, which is this. And what it means is anything to do with your educational curriculum or your studies at school, college, or university level. So we tend to mispronounce this word as academic. Let's have a look at that. So we go ahead and say then you got a cat sound after that, another followed by a mic. What did we get? We got academic. Academic. Let's fix that. The correct way to say this word would be ack. Then you get an A there, and a simple demic, just like in the word epidemic. So the correct way to say this word would be academic. And the one that you need to scrap is academic. So if it's related to your studies, it is not academic. It is academic. Your academic rigor, your academic curriculum, and so on and on. So if it has to do with your studies, it's not academic, it is academic, which is academic, academic. All right then, so we come to our sixth word, this right here, which means any voucher or any ticket which can help you avail a special offer, such as a discount or stuff like that. So the way this word goes wrong is when somebody pronounces this as coupon, coupon, right? So the wrong pronunciation will go something like coup, followed by un, which comes out to coupon. Right? Let's fix that there, shall we? So the best way to go about it is you've got coup followed by a pawn. Yes, the on must retain its original sound, which is on. Rather than the on turning into an un, you need to keep it at on. So you've got coupon. Another alternative pronunciation is C-E-W-P-O-N. You can take either, both are correct. You've got coupon, which is the British version, and the Americans tend to give some heat to the U as well, the U sound in there too. So they come out with coupon. So you've got coupon as well as coupon, and you're going to avoid the wrong one, which is coupon. So coupon turns into coupon or coupon. All right, so we are at word number 7, which is this word right here. And the word means type, a certain type of something. For example, type of music, type of literature, and so on and on. So this word is to be pronounced as genre, as opposed to the wrong versions, which might go such as genre or genre even sometimes. The correct way to go about this word is to pronounce it as genre. So what's your favorite music genre? And you would say something like pop or maybe blues, something like that. So genre means type, and the way to pronounce it correctly is something like this. You've got J-O-N followed by R-A. What do you get? You get genre. Now let's clarify that further. J-O-N should not be taken on its face value as John. You might end up with a mistake, which is genre. You need to change the J, and the way to do it is to think of the English word pleasure. Let's write that down, shall we? So we've got P-L-E-A-S-U-R-E. What do you get? Pleasure. Now the sound which the S and U collectively receive over here is the J sound. You've got ple-j-re, pleasure. So the J sound should be substituted over here for this J, and you are left with J and not J. What does that give you? Genre and not genre. The A must not be enunciated or focused on too much. Don't accent it, don't lay stress on it. This is just there to make the pronunciation perfect. So, because if I take it away, I'd be left with genre or something like that. But the best way to pronounce it is genre. So if I'm talking about a type of music, a type of painting, a type of literature, or anything like that, I will use the word genre. For instance, if you're at an art gallery, so what genre is this? Or what genre literature do you like reading? And so forth. So G-E-N-R-E comes out not as genre or genre, rather it comes out to genre, genre, genre. All right, coming to some home improvement, we have this word right here, which means the guy who fixes your faucets, looks after the water connections and so forth. And this guy is mistakenly known as the plumber. Notice the B sound in there. What did I just say? I said plumber. All right. Now, how to fix this word? This is a common error. People tend to believe that the B must be pronounced. But if I were to fix this word, I would take the B away. And I am now left with something such as plumber, plumber. So next time, if you need to call the guy who is going to take care of the water connections or anything going wrong with the pipelines and so forth, who do you call? No, not Ghostbusters. You're going to call the plumber and not the plumber. P-L-U-M-B-E-R has the B silenced, which comes out to plumber. So that's plumber. All right, coming to the animal kingdom now. So I start with the king of the jungle, that is the lion. Pretty simple word on the face of it, but the reason why I've taken it up is that some children, or perhaps some of us, were also wrongly led to believe that the pronunciation is loin. Now that needs to be corrected. And how? The reason for that is that if you are to mispronounce it as loin, things can get horribly wrong because you alter the meaning altogether. Now I do not intend any indecency over here, but I must inform that loin, or you know, something like L-O-Y, loin, the wrong version. Loin means the human genitalia, the reproductive organ. So imagine what a folly it would be if you were to mix up the pronunciations. So the correct way to go by it is L-I-E-N, lion. So who's the king of the jungle? No, certainly not that, but beg your pardon again, it is lion. All right, so the animal, the king of the jungle, is not known as the lion, but the lion. So that's L-I-O-N, lion. Okay, coming on to the name of a very popular fabric, which is this. And this is mispronounced something as corduroy. You might have heard somebody say corduroy pants, corduroy jeans, and so forth, but let's go ahead and rectify that. The correct way to pronounce the name of this fabric is either you've got your K-O-R, and you follow that up with a droy, or you even have another version, which is K-O-R-D-E-W-R-O-Y. So these two, both are correct. Which one to choose? You can choose either. For some information, I'll mention here that K-O-R-D-R-O-Y comes out to be corduroy. All right, corduroy is the British version. The Americans lay some emphasis on the U sound in there as well, and they pronounce it as corduroy. So there's a subtle hint of the U in there. You've got corduroy, or you have corduroy. Corduroy is the British equivalent, and the American version is corduroy. That. So you do not wear corduroy pants, jeans, or trousers, but what you do wear are corduroy jeans, corduroy pants, and corduroy trousers. So C-O-R-D-U-R-O-Y comes out as corduroy or corduroy. That. All right, attending some more solemn matters now, we come to the word B-U-R-Y, which is often mispronounced as bury. We'll come to the correct pronunciation in a bit, but let's discuss the meaning. So B-U-R-Y means to lay the dead into the ground, into the earth, in a coffin or otherwise. So when you put somebody into the earth, you use the word not B-U-R-Y as bury, but bury. So B-U-R-Y might on its face give the sound of bury, but the pronunciation is bury. So let's take up a sentence. Her uncle was buried in this cemetery. So buried. The past tense will also be buried, and the present tense will be bury and never bury. So to lay the dead into the ground, into the earth, is pronounced as bury, as opposed to the wrong one, bury. B-U-R-Y, bury. All right, word number 12, which is this. Now, I'm sorry, I'm going to get a bit more morbid because the word bury got me going, but there are two other words which are similar to, which are related to the word bury, which we must discuss over here. This word right here, where the dead are buried, like we just discussed, this place is often mispronounced as cemetery, which is geometry. In geometry, symmetry means proportion, but that's going to alter the meaning entirely for this word over here. So what do you call the place where the dead are buried and resting? That place is not a cemetery, but a cemetery. Yes, the word is very close to the way it's written. Let's break this down into the sounds. We get something like sem, little a sound in there, and you've got T-A-R-Y. What do you have? Cemetery. Cemetery, a little E sound or an R sound, and followed by terry. So the place where people are laid to rest, where dead people are laid to rest, is known as a cemetery and not cemetery. So what do you have in a cemetery? You have burial places of people, the people who are deceased. That brings me to another word which must be discussed over here is this. Another word for a burial ground, burial place, is T-O-M-B, which is again mispronounced as tomb, whereas the correct pronunciation is T-O-O-M-B. Mind you, these are not the correct spellings. These are the phonetic spellings. The correct spellings are these, T-O-M-B, but the word is to be pronounced as tomb. So I started from bury, we came to cemetery, and finally we ended up at tomb. Bury, cemetery, and tomb. So almost towards the end of the session, I thought we would venture into a word with Latin roots. You have B-O-N-A-F-I-D-E, which is not bona fide, but bona fide. In English, the basic meaning of this word is genuine or real. And if you talk about legal terms, it is used sometimes to signify the domicile of a person, their place of origin, and so forth. But the basic meaning remains at genuine or real. So folks often tend to mispronounce it and take it on the face value. They tend to pronounce F-I-D-E as fide, whereas the correct version of the pronunciation is bon, double A, which is A, F-A-I, phi, and D, double E. What do you have? You have bona fide. Instead of the often mispronounced bona fide, the word needs to be pronounced as bona fide, which means genuine or real, B-O-N-A-F-I-D-E, bona fide. That's the word. So word number 13 isn't exactly a word, it's more of a suffix. So a suffix is a partial word which combines towards the latter part of other words to give rise to a new word altogether. Now, lugy, L-O-G-Y, in the combining form is also ology. Let's get the pronunciation straight here. Lugy, by the way, means a branch of knowledge. That's the basic meaning. So L-O-G gets the same sound that, let's consider the English word smudge, S-M-U-D-G-E. So the U-D-G-E get the uch sound, which is something which is imported into this word. And L-O-G also gets the lutch from smudge. You got lutch. So what do you have? Lugy and not lodgy. You mustn't stress on the O vowel there. And so as to pronounce as lodgy, rather you should stick to the lugy sound. From smudge, you got lugy or ology. So when this suffix combines with various other words, what do you get? You get certain branches of study, which you can read over here. Now the reason we are discussing this suffix is that people tend to divide these sounds, the syllables in these words, at the wrong places. For instance, a speaker would divide this word somewhere over here, and they would end up pronouncing this as biology, which is not the way to go. The correct split would be bi as one sound, and you've got ology as another. What do you get? You don't get biology, you end up with biology. Similarly, the wrong split for the word ecology would be somewhere here, when the speaker says something like ecology, which should not be the case. I take away the split here as well, and I divide the word so, E and ecology. What do I get? Ecology. Ecology being one sound and E being the other. So what do you get? Ecology. Similarly, a wrong split for the word sociology would be somewhere here. When a speaker goes, sociology. Let's change that too. Let's rectify that. You put so and sociology. What do you get? Sociology.
So all the branches of study, be careful when you divide the sounds. You've got the suffix logy there, and you have biology, ecology, and sociology. And that's how the word, the suffix logy works.
So we finally arrive at our last set of words, which are H-O-T-E-L and R-E-S-T-A-U-R-A-N-T. Fairly simple words. I know most of you out there pronounce them correctly, but there are those who tend to mispronounce. Let's see the wrong ones vis-a-vis the right ones. So H-O-T-E-L is generally mispronounced as H-O-T-U-L-L. It comes out as hotel, which is the incorrect version. The correct one being H-O-T-E-L-L, hotel. So where do people from out of town stay, spend the evening, spend the night? They spend it at not a hotel, but at a hotel. So that's the first word, H-O-T-E-L, hotel. We come to the second one. You've got restaurant, as opposed to the wrong version, which is restaurant. There's no involvement of any sort of rent. There's just a charge for whatever you eat. So restaurant can have three alternative pronunciations. Let's have a look. So you've got R-E-S-T, R-O-N-T. Then you also have R-E-S-T with an O in there, R-O-N-T, and finally R-E-S-T with or without an O, and simply R-O-N. Let's elaborate on these. The first one, the first and second, are both British as well as American. You can choose alternatively whichever you find more pleasing for your throat or easier to deal with. The first one is restaurant. Then you've got restaurant. Over here, we've got a hint of O, a subtle hint of O, but not a very pronounced one. Restaurant. And finally, the French one. The French generally do not pronounce the last letters of their words. So the last letter here being T will be truncated or omitted, and you'll be left with restaurant. Restaurant. The T syllable in there is going to be softened into a T, leaving you with restaurant. So you've got restaurant, restaurant, or restaurant. This is the British version, coming to the more American version, and finally the French one, restaurant, restaurant, and restaurant. So there you have it, hotel and restaurant. So folks, that's it. We come to the end of the list of words which are mispronounced. I sincerely hope you found this useful. If you have, please go ahead and share it. Please subscribe to us. Please like the video. Like I always urge you, it helps us come back to you with more useful matter. Till then, what I'm going to do is, it's a cold day here in January and my hands are practically freezing. So I'm going to head out to a restaurant cafe, grab me a hot cuppa and enjoy my evening. Till then, you guys keep watching. Thank you so much. Take care.